Trumped.
Not me.
That's Eggmother, that's you.
It wasn't me.
That's you.
I'd have to leave my cheek up to get that one out.
Oh. It's a nice little town, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, we had a pretty nice drive up here today. We're gonna, in the background, there's Cirque de Gavarnie, quite a famous landmark. We're in a national park. Took the little bike out today, big mountain pass up there, over that, keeps going. Altitude of 2,100 and odd meters, enjoyed that. Actually, good view from up there. But yeah, we're gonna get on the monkey bike tomorrow and go into town and then take a walk and see this pretty amazing place. But for now, I think we'll have an early night, a bit knackered. Well, it's a beautiful day for a walk. Yeah, this place is pretty special. Just can't believe the view's real. Feels like it's some kind of painting you're looking at. Well, we're going to be setting off further east today. Just using this service point to empty our wastewater and to fill up with fresh. We are running a bit low. rainy day today, so we've come to Lourdes or Lourdes, some religious place where people come to be blessed. Apparently we're not religious, but like a bit of architecture, so we're gonna check it out. Well, there's a lot of people here taking this very seriously, as you'd imagine. Louise said it's the closest she's ever been to being inside of a lunatic asylum. Yeah, this place is a bit weird. There's like little lanes to fast track ill people in carts up to the chapel, like, so they can, I don't know, pray for getting better. Obviously, modern medicine isn't helping them much. Good old prayer might help, maybe. Who knows? Pretty good to kill a couple of hours. Have a look around the fort. Quite interesting. It's the best of worlds, feeling like nothing can go wrong. You're the decider of the world that you get to know. 'Cause it's your heart, it's alive, it's pumping. shit.
Blood.
So, something absolutely terrible has just happened. I'll try and keep this brief, and the reason I'm documenting this is because shitty things do happen when you're travelling, and this is one of those scary moments, like unbelievably scary, and I haven't got anyone to talk to about it just now, so it's just a way of getting it off my chest, and maybe Isaac can look back at this as some kind of crazy thing that happened. But so anyway, we're driving through the desert, right, through the national park there, and he was kind of like not very well, saying it was hot and stuff and felt dizzy and things, and I was knowing Isaac's really ill because he sounds fake. When he's faking being ill or for whatever reason, he's pretty convincing. When he's like blatantly, it just sounds fake, that's when he's really ill. So as we're driving along, all of a sudden he just vomited like easily nearly a litre of blood, projectile vomited everywhere twice, and then he started to lose consciousness. And when you're a kid, you see them and you think they've died in front of you. You went blue. Oh, I thought he just died right in front of us. He managed to keep conscious for a while. And then, he just threw up again. There's blood all over the cabin everywhere. So we managed to get him to a local hospital, which was luckily only 12 miles away from where we were, and they gave him a blood transfusion and then put him in an ambulance, and now we're in, I can't pronounce the name, the big city though, Pamplona. He's been transferred there because there's a kid's ward, and he's now in intensive care. We still don't know what's the matter with him. But yeah, it was pretty scary, and I'm not allowed to stay in there. Oh, only one of us is. Louise is going to stay there tonight, but we really don't know what's the matter with him. But yeah, just needed to really get that off my chest, and just for Isaac's sake, really. Hopefully we'll laugh about this one day, but I doubt it. It's pretty nasty. Right, I'm going to call this day two. Obviously get to the hospital. The staff at the hospital were really cool, actually. They told me about this place, which is a library, which is like 10 minutes walk away. Free parking. There's a few campers and stuff around, which is pretty good. But I'm gonna have to clean some of this mess up. It's over the windows and everywhere, because if the police pop the head in, they're gonna think I've bloody killed someone in here. So hopefully see what's going on. Okay, day three at the hospital. Not awful news, some pretty good news actually. Yesterday was like just a roller coaster. They finally took him off the blood transfusion, put a camera down his throat, checked all his stomach, his upper intestine, and also another procedure to check his nose, because he thought it was some like weird nosebleed thing that goes down the back and into your stomach, and then you're sick. It wasn't either of those areas, which led to the lower stomach, which would have been the problem area or the serious thing if it was going to, because it'd mean internal bleeding. He was anemic, obviously, because he's lost so much blood, so his red blood cells were down, and they needed to check and monitor that, because if it didn't go back up again, it'd mean he'd had internal bleeding still. Anyway, after last night, they've checked him, and they think he's not bleeding internally anymore. They're going to check it, they're going to leave him along today to recover, and then put some sort of dye in him or something tomorrow, and they can check where this mucus stuff is, and hopefully we'll get some more solid answers. I've just had to make myself some food because I haven't eaten yet, and it beat me, this thing. But I just had to make the most calorie full thing I could find, just to try and me and Louise, we've realised we're gonna have to look after ourselves, because if we're not right, it's going to be difficult to look after him. So yeah, fingers crossed, hopefully better news or more positive news soon. So this is day four, lunchtime. Results are still mixed, coming in, waiting for the big doctors to come and see us. They've just popped back to their truck for a drink, but yeah, it's getting a bit much now, really. Kind of really worried, we should expect. Luckily, parking's free Saturday afternoon, Sunday. Sunday's today, so Isaac's just, where is he? He's just a bar, I think. So we can keep our eye on things from up there, out the window. But yeah, we've been up there kind of 16, 17 hours a day. So yeah, anyway, hopefully there'll be progress real soon. Day five in the hospital, still no sign of what's actually wrong with him. It's Monday morning now. I think everywhere, like the testing facilities, were probably closed over the weekend, but yeah, he's going to be wheeled in hopefully soon for a lower scan, see if we can see anything again. But yeah, we're staying optimistic. Well, end of day five, after a pretty shitty start, actually. Just kind of got on top of me a bit this morning, and still not knowing what was wrong with Isaac. I think they found out what the problem is finally. But yeah, I'll explain more about that later. But yeah, just going back to the truck now. I'm parking at the library because parking is free during the week. It's free at the hospital at the weekend ish Saturday afternoon's free and Sunday, so I'm gonna go back and get some sleep. Louise is staying with him again, and hopefully we'll get a proper confirmation of what's wrong with him, and hopefully can have a small operation. And it's gonna take about a week to recover, I think, but it's a really good hospital, so yeah, fingers crossed. After he's had some tests today, some more tests, small steps, but actually massive leaps, really, because he was able to drink some water for the first time, and some little bit of fruit juice. So that's great news. I like it down here in the library car park. It's pretty quiet, and I'm parked just over there, as you can see. There's a few other camper vans down here and sort of small motorhomes that I think people are living in full time. So it's not on any of the sort of park for night places or anything. But yeah, I mean, I guess people are keeping eyes on each other's vans, I suppose. But it's a pretty quiet place, tucked out the way, and best of all, like I said, it's free, so you don't have to worry about running the meter or anything like that. Well, another good thing about the truck is obviously, as well as being so high up and you feel really safe, is that when I pull the blinds down at night, it's a total blackout, so I can have the lights on in here and no one's got a clue I'm even in it. Morning 7 in Pamplona, just getting up to the hospital. Isaac had his nuclear medicine test yesterday, which is basically they put radiation in him. It's kind of like a reverse x-ray, show you how things working. That didn't flag anything up. Good news is he's out of intensive care now, and he had half a yogurt yesterday, so that's quite a big thing. Yeah, fingers crossed, let's see what today brings. End of day 8 and a little catch up. Isaac's had a CT scan, been in the MRI machine. Didn't flag up anything. He had started to poo last night and he had blood in his first poo. Didn't have any blood in his second, or not as much, but he's bleeding again internally. So they need to find out where that's coming from still. He swallowed a camera capsule today, so I'm hoping that they're going to see where that is in his digestion system. Still optimistic, still fingers crossed, still very, very knackered. But yeah, what if you're ever going to get sick here. The healthcare and the hospital is just amazing. There's places that you end up in your life sometimes, and it's not because you particularly want to be there, but you become very fond of them. And Pamplona's just one of those places. It's weird, there's all kind of high-rise blocks everywhere, but it's city planning really works. Everyone's out in the streets at night, all sitting out dining, kids sat on benches. It's like everyone's outside living. It's really well executed, whatever they did when they designed and built this city. And it's actually a place that me and Louise had spoke about we quite like to live. So just need to get some sleep now, just really tired. So more updates tomorrow. Well, end of day 9. Today's been a bit of a shitty day, really. They got the results back from the capsule camera and they couldn't see any sign of where this bleeding's coming from. So they wheeled him in for an operation straight away and took all his lower intestine out. Basically lay it on a table, went through it all by hand, couldn't find anywhere where it's coming from again. Put it back in him and then sewed him up. Might have to leave these updates for now. It's pretty upsetting, actually. And I can't ever see an end to this. And I just got a feeling it's going to end up really bad. So maybe I'll check in if I've ever got any good news. You're right, Isaac. How are you feeling? Bueno. Muy bien. Vale. Vale, vale. Well, after 19 days in hospital, Isaac's finally well and fit for the journey home. So we're going to take a little while now, a couple of days, to do the 15 hours driving plus across France. So we're going to leave now and see how we get on. I'm scared of all that I don't know, 'cause I want it more. Not the perfect way to start this trip back. We're kind of having trouble. Find out what it is though. There's the injector pipe there has been rubbing on that water pipe and it was squirting diesel everywhere. So I've got some of that liquid metal stuff, you know, that putty. So I've just wrapped it around there. Hopefully it'll keep it from pissing out everywhere before we get on. Right, that repair didn't work. We found an hour near Berwick. So we're gonna stay here tonight. Main thing is that kid is fixed. Don't really care about, well, I do care about the truck. So we're gonna try and work out what we're gonna do. Yeah, but for tonight, we're just gonna chill out. Maybe have a walk over the beach there. So at least we can say we've been coast to coast. When you say that you know how I feel when it's wrong, and we've been right for years. But, we've been well looked after at the man truck dealers over there. They can get the part for us in 2 days, but because we're in a bit of a panic and we could really do with getting home, they're gonna get one made specially for us. The injector pipe's split, or it's rubbed between that and another pipe. So they've really been really good, gone above and beyond really. So yeah, we're gonna stay here this afternoon and this evening, and then they assure us it's gonna be ready for tomorrow morning, that they're gonna fit it for us. So good. Jeez, these guys have been super quick here. I was expecting this to arrive tomorrow at 12. They've just popped it back on now, and it's the same day before 3. So they're just writing up our bill now, and we'll be on the road the same day. Just top quality service from this place. If any of you guys in man trucks are stranded around Berwick, these guys will really look after you. We love that you like what we do, so please give us a thumbs up, leave a comment and subscribe to us either on YouTube or on our website, CampervanCulture.com. On the website you can check out our shop, where we stock all of the gear we like to use and much more. If you can't wait until our next upload, why not catch up or re-watch an old one? This one is a good one.